kind of nice to have folks sitting around the table, yes?
Well, to follow up a little bit, the, you know, right now we're here because, I guess, the lens is on the ballot to be voted on. Okay, and that, everybody says, well, we want peer, but the lens goes down, what next? So what assurance can this committee, I guess, to look at, is the next structure, it's not going through the same type of process? I think that's a key to this thing too, is that, right now we're just looking at the lens, then we vote down, up or down, then you talk about, well, we want peer. Well, you gotta build something into this process that corrects, if that's the right word, or attention to account what happened this career, so that we don't get to the next one and go through the same thing of putting it on ballot or another. To me, we're here, this process has gotta really learn from that, and what can we do? Are we sure that people want a peer, and if we're sure people want a peer, to design and get the input so that everybody buys in to whatever comes out of that? For me, that's crux of all, especially right now.
Very good point, you never get everybody, but you surely want a very, very strong community buy-in as a result of the process. Do you have something? Sorry, I thought you did.
Yeah, I think that one of the things we have to be very careful of is to raise the level of expectation here of what can be done. I mean, there's people sitting out there that sat with us through a year and a half's worth of meetings, and, you know, so what I want to make sure is that people don't expect that, because I'm going to say right now to you, James, I come into your office, and I say to you, this is what I want done. Now, you have people working 8 or 18 hours a day. Can you get what we have been asked to do here done by the 28th of August? And my expectation is that you probably can. So we're spending 2 hours a week, not 50 hours a week, trying to come up with this process. So we better narrow our scope so that when we end this process, we don't have the same type of criticism that they had for a year and a half process. So I think we need to make sure that we say we can get something done and we get that done, and don't overpromise what it is that we can get done. I think that, you know, our city engineer over there would probably love to retire if somebody told him they wanted him to do all of the information that he got together. Only let's bring it up to today's standards. We got this information in 2009, some of it a lot earlier, and this is no day at the beach for them to come up with this, and I'm not sure that they could in the time frame that we have. So I think we need to make sure that we have something that we can offer, and we don't promise too much, but we fulfill what it is that we say we can do. Because here we are in our second meeting at 4 o'clock, or just about 4 o'clock. We have one not a week from today, but further down. And then we'll have 4 weeks after that. And we've talked about subcommittees, and we've talked about, you know, all these other things. Let's take a look at the report, and I really want everybody to take a look at that report. We did spend a lot of time on it, and while I don't agree with everything that's in the report, it's a report that a committee that I was on did, and I supported it with the rest of the committee. But the last thing we can afford with the citizens of St. Petersburg is to tell them we're going to do something, and the 28th rolls around, and we didn't do it. So we need to either say we need more time than that in order to ensure that the process that we come up with is a good process, not just a process that we were able to do in 6 weeks, or 2 hours
a day. Yes, very good point. I don't know that, talking to a number of you individually, that anybody much disagrees with what you just said. In other words, to finish this by that particular date, finish this and have specific recommendations ready to go forward.
Yeah, I would like to say a couple of things. One, it was a little, and I'm not sure I heard this correct, but one of my assumptions was that the original task force did a lot of work and talked to a lot of people. And when I read that report, I kind of felt like it was something I could agree with too. And that's why I was hoping that that could be a basis that we could start from. And so I don't know if people said, well, that was the report, but when we got going and doing it, we did something different. And why did we do something different? That's, I think that's a little bit of what some people think is a problem, that somehow that we went, this whole report came through and then seemed like the report didn't get followed, so there was some kind of a disconnect. So I'm trying to figure out how that disconnect happened. And you seem to indicate that there was a disconnect.
Well, I can only talk about myself.
Well, you were there, right? Were you on the committee?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay. And I missed four meetings out of 64.
Oh, shit.
And then I'm surprised they even asked me back after that. Actually, I'm surprised they asked me back anyway, but because I'm so timid, I guess. But in any event.
One will take in and
That's what we need to figure out.
Yes, sir, but it emphasizes, I think, and you're right, all we've been doing is getting organized so far, but emphasizes the importance of this July 25th meeting. People hopefully will come in here ready to talk substance. And that's an important phrase, talk substance.
Well, one of the things that I've seen in my own personal experience in committees like this, you get unbelievably talented people together. And if you had them individually, they would go on and on and on and on. And with information that you'd love to hear. But you put them in a group like this, and all of a sudden, they get a little quiet. And so I know people here have opinions, and we need to make sure that we don't have too soft a shell, and we're comfortable not just reviewing that report, and then coming back and writing some questions. If you have a question, I think you need or a suggestion. I think we need to be able to be comfortable enough with this group to say, you know, Pop, you're full of it. or yourself.
If you want that,
right.
Fair enough. So I would suggest that we try to get things to you for people to review that are simple to find and would help educate people. So anybody that has knowledge that can do that, and we have a few ideas, so we'll send some stuff.
Great.
But it's the same kind of stuff as this. I mean, I think that's, like I say, I think that's the first piece, and then let's try to get the pieces.
Good. Well, I'll stand agree on that part. James?
Yeah, I just want to, again, restate what I said a few minutes ago. I think it speaks to everything what I'm trying to offer. It is from my point of view, a framework to get us to the 28th. I hope anyone's not afraid of the fact that I don't think we're going to produce this document. I don't think it's going to be this thick. You know, a process doesn't take a lot of paper if it's done right. But I think what's the work involved is all the appendix or the attachments that may support why we pick a process or why we say these 7 steps should be followed. Or 20 steps, whatever we devise. And one point of clarification, what I mentioned before was sort of the latter. What if the lens did not make it? I think you have all this stuff. If it do, I think the parts that I mentioned about education, I still think is the missing link to maybe why. And, you know, and on my own, I sort of perused the website, and I still haven't found answers to the questions of what went wrong. I don't know why. I mean, not very clear, except maybe someone really don't understand either the type of money in which had to be spent or the process and just don't understand it, or it just seems like a big project, you know. 50 million is a lot of money.
Still.
Yeah, I agree. And I think it doesn't have to be as complicated as we might want to make. I think we could look, the city's done a tremendous amount of work over this period of time, as many others have, in getting a proposal put together, the design competition, all of that. But there might be an element or two that could be reviewed in there and say, if you change that next time, it might be make all the difference. So if we could bone up on that piece, you know, which would be the process that was used before, and if that's in the summary, form or some other way and have available, if someone wants to do midnight reading, to have that available and get into the weeds in it if you want to. But there may be one or two items there that if we tweak that, it could be a really great process. I don't know, but it may not be overly complicated once we get educated. I think once we understand the process that went down.
Thank you, Jason.
Well, I just wanted to say I thought the task force did a great job, and I wish Ed Montaneri was here. Both he and Mr. Michaels, who were part of that task force, both said that they felt that the recommendations by the task force were followed in this process. So I don't know which parts we're going to look at to figure out which parts weren't and make them better, but I guess that's what we're mostly concerned with here. And thank you very much, Mr. Jamerson. Mr. Jackson, if we could just have like three or four main items to focus on, I think we could get a lot more accomplished, you know, like one at a time, and just mark it off the list there and move forward, because otherwise we're going to get bogged down and we're never going to get anything done.
It's great for us ADD people.
Anything else in a general sense?
Well, yes, my last comment, really, Director James, is something did go wrong, or we wouldn't be sitting here. And so, I don't know who can do his best to try to guide us and to help frame that question so that we figure that out and so it doesn't happen again. That's what just
one of the things they didn't include you. Okay, or they done they couldn't see in the water. So there's one. The 101 you should have asked the doctor if you could see in the water. Scientists to have a lens.
Scientists weren't asking. That's what I've been hearing all over the city.
Well, again, this concept of best practices maybe is part of summing up what we're going to try to do. So at least from a neutral person standpoint, it's a little less important that we need to know it. A little less important what went wrong or who did what to get things in our somebody's opinion wrong. Just make sure we get it right.
That's right.
It's not about politics and people, it's about trying to get something in place.
Exactly. Yes, sir. And everybody's going to hopefully enjoy it for many, many years. Anything else in a general sense before we open up to public comment? With that, we'd like to open it up to public comment. May I make a request? 1 second, please, and I'll get right to you. Whomever wants to make a comment, again, one at a time, please. And if you get enough to state your name so we get it down, we have a record, we know who's talking. That would be very nice. And please, sir, you're up.
My name is Robert Neff, resident here. When you're talking about the process, one of the things that comes to mind.
Can you do me a favor? If you will stand up, and then our court reporter can maybe hear you. And in fact, if you want to come over here a little closer, maybe we could all hear you.
From the camera?
Oh, yeah.
That'd be great.
Just make sure to smile. All right, we're going to start your 2 minutes now. You're on.
All right, someone has run a large-scale procurements. One of the things I'm not really hearing here is the process is what is the risk assessment and what is the risk mitigation? That is very critical. I think that was a major failure or not really emphasized on the last procurement that would happen. I think if they would have done this assessment using the history, they would have kicked back and said, hey, we've got a problem. 68% of people do not like these designs. I think also add what I added said last time, tourism and market research from a quantitative and qualitative aspect. Need to find out what the customer, us, the residents, want. Not only the age, but also the different genres, user personas. Open question is, for the permits, after 828, if it does, Lentz does pass and go forward, what's gonna happen if, the permits are not approved, or they force a redesign, or any questions with the height. The last statement is, or question is, will there be a website to post all these questions and all this information that you guys are going to have for a list of all these minutes in these meetings, for a list of all these peer task advisories and the videos? It'd be great for the public to have that in a website, compact, concise, where we can go click and get it, just like you did for the previous events. That's it.
Thank you very much. Yes, sir. Thank you, Bill.
William Mallard, professor in St. Petersburg, Florida.
Sorry, you're 2 minutes early.
Two things. I delivered a 15 copies of a letter to the chairman this morning, and we discussed whether it would help the meeting or hurt the meeting if it was released to you all. I'm asking the chairman to distribute those letters at the earliest opportunity.
We'll get them out tomorrow, Bill.
It touches on many of the things you talked about here today. In my letter, I made statements that clearly put portions of city staff in a bad light. That is in my statement to you last week. Some of why I made those remarks is explained in this letter. Now, Mr. Cerruti's idea of going back and looking at videos that predated the issuance of the Peer Task Force final report, to me, is kind of like starting a will contest. That committee is dead and done. Its legacy is that report. It is the composite work of 20 minds who certainly were not singing in unison and finally agreed on that report as their product. Ed Montanari and Will Michaels cannot interpret that report for you. Mr. Cerruti, I mean, he can, but the report stands on its own, or you can just have a will contest. And us lawyers love them. I thrived on them. They take days and days and lots of lawyer fees. You don't want to go there. What you do want to do, I think, is state your disagreement with conclusions, and that is a great way to find out where you are. But I said what I have to say. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Anyone else? Yes, sir.
Dan Harvey.
Never met you before.
Dan, get on the microphone.
Yeah, okay. You mind being over the mic and make it a lot easier. Right. Thanks for pointing that out.
Dan Harvey, resident of St. Pete. Bits and pieces of what everyone's been saying about the task force, where the thing might have got off course, the direction the city made it gave the designers. My point I want to make is that the interlocal agreement changed after the task force completed their work. The interlocal agreement was between the city and the county that said how the monies could be spent, where they could be spent. In some ways, the task force became obsolete because of the interlocal agreement change. It allowed the money to be spent on the uplands. So you have a different set of rules if you can spend the money on the uplands. Then the city came out in one of those documents you're asking for, one of the directives, and said, disregard the task force. It was well-intentioned but short-sighted. So when you add all those things up, the poor people that were designing the thing were kind of confused. Now, keep in mind, I make that point, the interlocal agreement says you can spend $50 million, you can spend it anywhere you want. I'll just let that stay in place. But the other thing I'd like to say is, Gary Grooms, who was the president of the Downtown Neighborhood Association, which pushed in this waterfront master plan, I sit on the board with him, and he thought he would, he was a little mad that he was not included in the possibility of sitting on this 828 committee. And I think you would have been a good support, because as I look around the room here, I see the two camps that Lee Green was talking about. I don't see a lot of people in the camp that are against the lens. It's kind of stacked pro-lens. So those are my comments.
Thank you very much. And
can I make a statement?
Absolutely.
Dan made some good points, but I'd also like to point out that the task force report does deal with the uplands, and they could have chosen things about the uplands after that happened. So the task force was not limited just to appear. It has a whole report on the uplands.
Probably when it relates back to family entertainment.
I mean, I guess they could have chosen to do the uplands and not have a pier.
Since that one off of Bayshore could have, is included in the...
Dan's pointing out they did allow, I guess you said it made it obsolete. I think it made it more useful because they had dealt with both the uplands and the pier, and what happened is, as they changed it, they said it could be used on both the uplands and the pier. Is that correct?
Yeah.
Both.
Yeah.